again, and welcome to United Wrestling Alliance Ringmasters. I am joined, of course, by Benjamin Halifax III.
And we got a week of incredible wrestling.
Benjamin, what is your problem? Settle down, my friend. We have a lot of things taking place this week. I can't...
Ladies and gentlemen, we interrupt your normal United Wrestling Alliance Ringmasters television program to bring you this special report. The United Wrestling Alliance on tour during the week, and one of the biggest bombshells in wrestling history came down.
Little Bob, I came to inform you that I can't wrestle tonight. Boom!
What? I have a foot injury.
Hello everyone, and welcome to United Wrestling Alliance Ringmasters. I am Johnny Kilgood. As you just saw at the top of we cut in with a special report here this week. A big card took place over the weekend in Warm Wart, Minnesota, where a big bombshell came down. Mark Stagg was set to lock up with Metal Bob for the world title, a big charity event, and instead Mark Stagg came out with a bombshell. His foot is broken. We don't know how long he's going to be out. He could be stripped of the title. We're going to find out here during this broadcast. We are going to bring you some of the matches from this big historical card, as a couple big things took place. The replacement for Mark Stagg in that match against Metal Bob, you are not going to want to miss. That's in the main event. We had a lights out match, a match that took place with no fans, a pure grudge match just to settle an issue between two men. That's MC McCracken and El Diablo Blanco. These two have not locked up on television as far as I can recall, but they did it in Worm Wart. And I'll tell you right now, we've got another big one. Tall Enough will take on the Intercontinental Television Champion. Non-title matchup, Rigar Mortis and Tall Enough. We're going to show you that. And I'm going to have here as my special guest, Mark Stagg, who was in Worm Wart. He's going to talk to me. He's going to commentate the matches with me that took place during the week. And we are going to find out if we can get to the bottom of this. We're going to show you his announcement in its entirety. Fans, we will be right back after these brief words with the first contest, a lights out match. Before the fans even got in the building, we did this one. We'll be right back. All right, fans, we have a big one coming up for you. MC McCracken and Miss Susan, excuse me, Psycho Susan and Psycho Shawn on their way to ringside.
This contest is scheduled for one fall.
You can hear the ring announcer there.
Coming down the aisle, being led by his manager, Psycho Susan, Psycho Shawn, MC Magtastic McCracken. Kraken! His opponent, from South Central East Los Angeles, he is known as El Diablo Blanco, weighing in at 200 pounds, Diablo Blanco! Blanco.
Y'all people in Bucks, get them out of home.
All right, fans, we are about to get into it hard and heavy here. It is Worm Wart, Minnesota. I am joined by Mark Stagg at ringside. Well, excuse me, not at ringside, at studio side, excuse me. I have not seen these matches thus far, Mark Stagg. These are all new to me. They were taped earlier in the week. I want to bring you in a little bit to comment on some of the matches, and we'll get to some of your comments in a little while. But it's good to have you here, champ.
Thanks for having me, John, and I'm great to be here, happy to be here. And I was here for this card, and this was right after I was injured. And thanks. And it's been an emotional week for me, finding out my foot was broken, and not knowing what's going to happen in the next couple weeks here. I don't know how long I'm going to be out for. It's all up to the doctors to to tell me when I can get back to the ring.
All right, first thing we have to do is apologize to the fans. These are raw, this is pretty much raw footage, one camera angle only, as we were just taping it for UW Archives, amphitheater home video, if you will, for a later edition. And the audio isn't going to be that great because it hasn't been edited or mixed or anything. We wanted to rush this right to you. But you can see these two right here are getting hard and heavy right into it, Mark Stagg. Look at that, MC Psycho Shawn McCracken. Now, when Shawn McCracken was a referee, you and he were very good friends. What happened to this guy?
Well, McCracken went the wrong way, just like Bombshell Billy did. And right now, both men in the ring, they both hate each other. Both men are not definitely fan favorites.
Look at that figure four leg lock. Ricky Grace in on the action. Look at that double team maneuver, Mark Stagg. That's the kind of stuff you gotta watch out for now that Psycho Sue and Psycho Shawn, I call them S squared. Now that these two are together, they're just a ball of trouble.
Double,
I tell you.
Double Psycho, if you're saying.
All right. Psycho Cube.
Sure.
And El Diablo, he speaks for himself. The stuff he's been doing with the Nightmare, those two have been tagging up around the country as of late. The Nightmare, of course, down in Puerto Rico, was scheduled to make his return this week on the regularly scheduled show. Hopefully we can get the regularly scheduled show. Oh, look at that diamond cutter like maneuver.
Right there, fantastic move there by El Diablo. Of course, I wrestled both these men before. Both men aren't great size, but they are very quick. And they use
there's a flying headbutt like
flying
the barbarian.
Headbutt. Both men use all the rules of the book.
Only a count of two here. Of course, in Wormwood, we were down in a chair. We were doing a charity event here. Of course, this was before the fans were let in. It was an intimate setting. There was only about 50 fans or so. It was all proceeds to benefit the youth organization programs for this particular gym where we were wrestling in. In Wormwood, and you're always part of these charity events.
I like to help out when I can. Unfortunately, in this charity event, this is where after I found out what was going on with my foot, and hopefully we'll find out a little more as the week goes on.
Well, you kind of antagonized the match to take the place of the main event with you, and it was a main event in any arena because it shocked me. I can't believe what took place, the replacement match. That Metal Bob had to wrestle, something I never thought I'd see, and we have never seen the two men wrestle who did here. We've never seen it on television. I never thought I would see it on television.
Fans definitely stick with this whole hour because that match is definitely phenomenal.
It's incredible. The fans in the arena, in the gym are just ecstatic. Now look at this, El Diablo getting in it with Rick Grace, and that's like and there's a big beaver. You like to use that.
I think you stole that one from my book.
You like to use that one.
I sure do.
Whips him into the corner there. Excuse me, into the ropes, back in the ropes. Oh, and there's a flying burrito.
I'm sure Billy taught him that one. It's definitely a devastating move.
Psycho Susan in the corner, egging on her man at all
Shawn
times.
Shawn never afraid. Ooh,
oh!
Flying headbutt right there.
My gosh.
By Kraken.
Only count of one there. Diablo grabbed Ricky Grace to pull himself out of that one. This man has more tricks than Houdini. Doug Henning, Blackstone, Copperfield, all put together. This Diablo Blanco.
Cracking, not afraid to go to the ropes.
Oh, there's a big forearm. Looked like down across the chest. Could have been the throat. One, two. Oh.
Only a count of two there.
Excuse me, I'm a little under the weather. I did not expect to be in the studio. I was rushed in from my home where I was sleeping to do this.
I just came from my doctor again.
We're going to get a medical report from Mark Stagg a little bit later on. We hope to.
I'm just waiting to hear. Well, pardon you, Johnny.
It's the audio in the arena here. Let's not forget, this is a lights-out contest. Before all the fans even got into the building, these two just wanted to settle it. One, two, and we taped it for amphitheater home video for a later process. But none of these matches have been edited. None of these matches have been sound clarity. This is all just raw footage we're bringing to you right here on UWA Ringmasters. A very special program for you here, fans.
I kind of feel...
Look at this, a crucifix, black maneuver.
There you go, covers him.
One, two. Oh, that was close.
I want to apologize for the fans because I feel like I'm letting them down here. But and I hope we're not showing this footage here just because of me. And there was some fantastic matches on this card.
I want to talk to you, Mark Stagg, a little bit later about how you got this injury to the foot. I know you were wrestling out of the country, defending the world title when this happened. And we want to talk a little bit about that. Look at these two going at it. Are you kidding me? El Diablo and Psycho Susan. And I, again, I apologize, fans. I'm under the weather. We couldn't even get Benjamin flown in from Lafayette to the studio because he was so busy today with his, you know, it's apple season.
He's
winding down, and he just couldn't tear away from his business. We weren't scheduled to do anything.
I heard he doesn't drive. I heard he takes a big bus.
Okay.
I heard he drives everywhere.
No, he takes a short yellow bus.
I heard he's afraid to drive.
We have
That's
a
why
new.
I'm sorry.
We have a new trivia contest.
Whoa, big drop
oh, look at
right
that.
There.
Nowhere to go on that. We have a big trivia contest we want to start here this week, Mark Stagg. Maybe you can help us out with it. I want to stump you a little bit, too. Actually, you and I can both be in on it because I don't know the answer to this. A little trivia contest we're going to give out throughout the show.
Sorry to interrupt you, Diane, but these two men have gone to the floor on the outside.
They have indeed. They have indeed. Oh, there's a knee into the midsection.
This gymnasium trains
referee
boxers.
Up to four.
And professional wrestling. Blue shoe at ringside.
Oh!
The size 13 to me.
My God!
Oh, just planted to the back.
11 the ref's up to. 13. 14. No. That's it. That's it.
That's it.
Of course, at the live events, we have ring announcers, so you can hear him piping in every once in a while. The ring announcer.
I have just been informed.
His name is
the referee,
Mo Dinkle.
Is a double.
And,
double
count out right there, we heard.
Double count out, and McCracken coming back in the ring to ask referee what's going on, and
Counter!
The referee has ended the match.
Oh, my goodness. He has indeed, and I want to, well, we're going to go to a commercial break, bring you a couple messages from the UWA. We're going to try to get this all back together for you. We're going to start the trivia thing, another new segment. This is a big, big show, Mark Stagg. You're going to be with me throughout. We're going to be talking to you a little bit. Let's take you to a message. From the UWA, and we'll be back with the trivia thing. I'm going to talk to Mark Stagg during the next match, which is Tallanuf and Rigor Mortis, non-title for the Intercontinental TV belt. We'll be right back. Did you ever wonder what happened to the War Eagle and Scotty McCloud, and if they'll ever return to the United Wrestling Alliance? What about Diablo? What's he going to steal next? Are Hard and Heavy ever going to get back together? And do they ever talk behind the scenes? You can find all this out one way and one way only, and that's by giving us your address so we can send you the United Wrestling Alliance newsletter. That's right, the United Wrestling Alliance newsletter, the official word of the United Wrestling Alliance. Write to us, make sure we have your address at Post Office Box 54, North Syracuse, New York, 13212. This newsletter is completely free of charge. If we have your address, we're going to send you the newsletter. What happened to the Russian Dragon? Where's his mask now? Will he ever come back? Well, the Thunder and Tiger and the Mystic, on their tour of Japan, who did they beat up? What's Teresa Steele's plans now that Bombshell Billy has retired? You can find all this out by writing to us and giving us your address so we can send you the United Wrestling Alliance official news bulletin, the UWA newsletter. We are going to give you all the late breaking news, including columns from Johnny Kilgood, interviews with wrestlers, also a column by Benjamin Halifax called The House of Halifax. Is the Disco Kid wear his mask all the time? Why does Metal Bob even wear a mask? You can find that out by writing to us. Please do it. Alright fans, welcome to Trivia Corner. I am John Kielgut. I'm here with Mark Stagg. We've got a big trivia one for you this week. We're going to do this throughout the next couple of weeks and see how the fan response is. And we might have some write-in contests too for special UWA prizes. But this week we just want to start things off with a little something I want you to play with yourselves at home. You can play along with us. We always encourage you to play with us. This we're going to show you. Let's bring it up. Now, in the background is a wrestler. This is taken during his rookie year, believe it or not. I don't know who it is. Mark Stagg does not know who it is. But this is a picture. Throughout the show, the next couple segments, we'll pull down a little bit more of the white screen so you can see who it is, and eventually we'll show you who this is. You're not going to believe this picture is what Magoo told me. I haven't seen it yet, nor has Mark Stagg. Here's a list of hints they gave me, so we're going to play along with you guys. Mark, why don't you give him the first hint?
The first hint on the list here is that he is a former World Tag Team Champion.
Former World Tag Team Champion. Have you ever been the World Tag Team Champion?
No, I
haven't. UWA? Really?
I held the World Tag Team Champion, no.
You have been a TV champion.
I have been TV champion and World Champion.
Speaking of which, I want to pull this down for a second. Well, the fans take a look at that, see if they can get anything out of it so far. I want to talk to you about your foot injury. Now, how exactly did this happen?
Well, I was wrestling down in Puerto Rico, and I was wrestling Jose Gonzalez.
Right.
And hit me with a baseball bat a few thousand times. Felt like, anyways.
You're defending the world title down in Puerto Rico.
Yes.
Wrestling Jose Gonzalez. I don't particularly care for that man.
No, I don't either.
Things got a little rough, and you're obviously whipping his ass from one pillar to the next post, and he pulled out a bat and cracked you in the foot.
That is correct.
And, I heard he had
actually, at this point, it's kind of even kind of blurry. It's kind of, I've kind of blacked out at the moment it happened and kind of put things out of my mind because I don't really want to remember, you know, what had happened because it was such a devastating injury at this point in my career, being World Tag Team Champion. And, you know, I don't at this point, I'm waiting to hear from Neon Dan Labaus as far as...
We will get that announcement today, what's going to go on with the belt, because you've been out already for a week since this card took place that we're showing today. You're going to be out for another at least 2 weeks, maybe three.
At least 2 weeks.
Hopefully, I know you want to make your return at Thanksgiving Thunder. So we're gonna get the word from Neon Dion and find out about that. But right now, we got to go back up to the... We got to go back, excuse me, to Wormwood, Minnesota. We're at a charity event. I wasn't there. You were there, Mark, where you made your bombshell announcement we showed earlier. We're going to show that in its entirety, plus a match that you're not going to believe that I have never seen before. I just never thought this match would take place, and it was spectacular, and it was brutal. We've already shown one match from it. Let's go. We've given the fans enough time with this. We'll come back to this a little later and show you a little more of it. Let's go back up to ringside, and we're going to show you, fans, exactly what took place in this next contest. It was non-title, the Intercontinental TV Champion, Rigar Morris against Tallanuf. This is going to be fantastic, fans. We'll be back right after this. So right now, why don't we go back to Wormswort and pick up the action. I believe that the ring announcer is about set to lock up.
From the Rocky Mountains, he weighs in at 420 pounds at 7 foot, 5.5 inches tall, enough! His opponent is the current Intercontinental Heavyweight Wrestling Champion.
How tall is that boy?
From parts unknown, coming to us from the AAA promotion of Mexico City, Mexico, weighing in 212 pounds, Rigar Mortis.
All right, Rigar Mortis set.
This
is non-title. He is in the ring right now. This ought to be something from Wormwood, Minnesota. You can hear the fans, a throng in attendance here, chanting for Tall. This ought to be a fantastic contest, Mark Stagg.
She's a great one indeed. And look at the size advantage right there for Tallanuf.
Tallanuf is a huge, huge man, but you have to remember this. Oh my gosh! Oh!
He is huge.
That's
and he also has power.
That's decapitation out there. Again, fans, we are cutting into our regular program with this one. Mark Stagg has joined me in the studio. Benjamin could not get away. We were pulled out of nowhere. I was in bed, quite frankly, when they asked me to come and do this one. And you can hear it. We are, of course, this is a charity event. And so I'm not up to par.
Look at the power right there of Tallanuf.
This Tallanuf is a huge man. He's very
But getting strong. Up, Rigar Mortis. Nothing stuns this man.
Coming out to the throng in attendance, the charity event that we were at Wormwood. And there's a good 50 fans here. We only let a select few in. It was $100 a ticket. 50 fans were let in only, 50 people, and all that money went to this gym in Wormworth that was about to go under. It was a boys' club. We came in, and we did this charity event to raise money for it and kept them in business. That's what we do here in the UWA. That's the kind of people we are. And look at this Tallanuf. Oh, a knee. Looked like a big knee.
Yes, it did. Rocked the big man. Knocked
double
him down.
Knee to Tallanuf.
That's the thing you want to do with this Tallanuf is get him off his feet.
Look at that, spinning toe hold, drops back on it, putting pressure on the ACL right there, the anterior cruciate ligament.
I have yet to face Rigor Mortis here in the United Wrestling Alliance.
Have you wrestled Tallanuf at all?
I've been in tag team matches
right. Okay.
Along with him, but...
You're in a four-way with him, I believe.
Yes.
As well as a match. Look at that leg drop, working on the big knee. That's what most of the opponents do here, Mark Stagg. Would you agree with this? Work on the legs of Tallanuf to knock him down?
Correct. Once you get him off his feet, this is a bad move, getting him back on his feet.
Oh, look at him into those ropes. Oh, he goes for a clothesline. Looked like it was in the midsection region. He couldn't even jump high enough to get him in the throat because Tallanuf's 15 foot 70. Look at this. The fans are rabid here at ringside in Wormwood. What's he going to do here now?
Aerial attack.
Oh, a big splash. That was all the way across the ring, too.
Now, if you don't hook a leg, then that was some bad tactics right there by Rigor Mortis.
You can't pin a man this size with his credentials without hooking a leg. This Rigor Mortis from the AAA promotion down in Mexico.
Now, correct me if I'm wrong, but I believe Tallanuf is the king of the battle royal.
He is the king of the battle royals. Diablo Blanco would like to contest that. He's won about four or five of them himself. My gosh, he is the king of the weapons battle royal, I'll give you that. Oh, look at that big foot to the back. Another one. And coming up right after this, Mark Stagg, is your announcement. You're going to be sitting here with me during it. Then we've got a match that you actually put together, I guess you could say. I just can't believe that.
Yes, I did the win.
We've got more trivia coming up. We've got the rest of the trivia. Listen to the fans out there. Oh my gosh, they are really chanting.
Barnyard chants, I believe.
Yeah. We're in Wormwood. Well, they're in Wormwood. We're in the studio.
I was there.
Mortis, they're chanting Mortis. Oh, come on now. Oh, and there's a kick to the knee of Rigor Mortis, the Intercontinental TV champion.
A little payback there from Tallanuf.
This is non-title. Rigor would not put the title on the line against Tallanuf. Tallanuf said, fine, I'll take a non-title match. I'll whip your ass, then you'll have to give me a title match. So that's what he's going to try to do here.
To do what?
Huh?
To do what?
Whip his ass.
Oh, okay.
Fans, you have to excuse me again. I was pulled right out of bed. A moon's over my hammy. And brought into
what
the studio.
Huh? The days before you came
in? Yeah. Oh, okay. I went to Lenny. Whips him in.
Big whip.
Oh, there's a shoulder tackle that takes Rigor down. One of these two men are going to have to give. Tallanuf won't give because he's so big. But Rigor Mortis just keeps coming back. He can absorb the punishment that Tall gives him.
Definitely seen Rigor Mortis take some serious punishment.
Look at him caught in the ropes there.
I've seen normal men just go down in pain with, but he has some extraordinary tolerance for pain.
I can't hear what the fans are chanting at these men. Oh my goodness, please.
I think of a prop to Ricky Grace.
Ricky Grace.
He did a phenomenal job since he's been in the United Wrestling Alliance.
Yep. I got a big shout out to our very good friend Brian Kristopowicz has rode in again. It's good to hear from him again, my friend, and that information you requested will be coming up in the next month or so. So stay tuned for that.
I wrote your letter this week, and I hope that the match at Halloween Hell did live up to your expectations.
That's right. Double fireballs. I'd like to talk about that with you, Mark, but we don't have enough time today, but I do want to get, I don't know what the hell, you and Devastating Dare, oh, we missed him with the foot there. You and Devastating Dare are supposed to be best friends. You double fireballed each other, could have blinded each other for life.
Well,
I don't understand, but we'll get to that at another time. Look at them cutting down the legs of Tallanuf, and I have to say that main event lived up to everything. That was an incredible contest between two fine athletes. You two put everything on the line.
Well, thank you, Tony.
Oh my gosh, they're calling Rigor Mortis the devil here in Wormwood. Anything different walks through Wormwood, and I guarantee you they either lynch it or they call it the devil. All right, then we gotta go to a big swing and a miss. The fans a little bit unruly here. Oh my goodness. You have to excuse us fans. Tallanuf giving us a view that I don't think we wanted. I didn't see anything up there. It looked like a Ken doll. It looked like a Ken doll. I didn't see anything. Wait a minute.
Show us the under.
Oh, he's going at it with a fan here.
Yes, Chandler's a
he's
fan.
Inviting the ring. Yeah, I don't think that's going to happen. Not in this lifetime.
Of course, I was here for this, and I saw that fan. Let me tell you, for his sake, I'm glad he didn't get in the ring.
Yeah. He didn't know whether to slap him or to leave him in the crowd. Look at him. Fire it up tall, they're saying. Fire it up.
This man does not need any motivation, but...
Look at this. Nose to nose. Oh, and there's a big clubbing forearm. And that forearm is giant. It's not like a regular forearm, like my forearm, or even a big forearm like yourself. That's just a huge forearm.
Incredible.
It's like a leg.
Forearm.
It's like a filthy leg. Oh, my God.
They call it the big ma cha.
That is a big ma cha by Tallanuf. Is that going to... Holy cow, you're kidding me.
He got him. I can't
believe
it.
Oh, my God. He is. Oh, my goodness. Listen to this. Oh, my God. Tallanuf with a big, big win. We're back in the studios with Mark Stagg. We're going to go to another special announcement here. And then we're going to come back with a little bit more of the trivia. I'm going to talk to Mark Stagg a little bit more. Then we've got the bombshell announcement and a huge match. You're not going to believe this. You are not going to believe it, fans. We'll be right back after this call.
Did you ever want to pick the brain of the United Wrestling Alliance president, Neon Dion Lobatos? Well, now you can. It's as simple as picking up a pen and jotting down the address of the United Wrestling Alliance. He'll answer your questions. Ask him anything you like. Pick up a pen and write it down. United Wrestling Alliance Ringmasters, Post Office Box 54, North Syracuse, New York, 13212. That's United Wrestling Alliance Ringmasters, P.O. Box 54, North Syracuse, New York, 13212. And attention, wrestling fans, we need your help. That's right, the United Wrestling Alliance is requesting your help in picking the main event for Thanksgiving Thunder. Thanksgiving Thunder to take place at the end of Thanksgiving. It's going to be a giant, spectacular card, and you can get in on the ground floor by picking the main event. Just write to us at United Wrestling Alliance Ringmasters, P.O. Box 54, North Syracuse, New York, 13212. Send us your comments, send us your questions. I guarantee you, we'll get back to you.
All right, fans, that can mean only one thing. We're back with trivia. I'm John Kielgud. I was pulled literally out of bed to do this special live broadcast with Mark Stagg, big bombshell with Mark Stagg, hurting his foot, and he can't compete for a while here. We don't know the status of the world title. That'll be coming up. Let's get back to the trivia right now. We already showed you this part. Let's show you a little more here. Oh, all right. Mark, you have the second hint for us.
Who the hell? What? I mean...
Mark, I'm
sorry, I'm thinking to myself here. Thinking out loud. Trying to figure out who this is. Now, you have the next clue here? I have the next clue?
You have the next clue.
I have the next clue. Okay. This man has had two managers.
Two managers at the same time, or is it two different? Doesn't say?
Doesn't say.
Just two managers?
Managers.
All right, this man, this wrestler, has had two managers. This is a snapshot again, Magoo says, of his rookie year. In the world of wrestling.
Hot pink.
Hot pink, and I see a bright, bright green. I'm not really sure who this can be. Pull this down for a second, Mark. Coming up, we have your bombshell announcement. We give the fans a second or two to soak this in. We have your bombshell announcement. We show at the top of the program. We're going to show the whole thing in its entirety. You were set to take on Metal Bob, and you pulled pulled up lame. You couldn't do the actual match. So you kind of threw together a match here out of, I guess you kind of called a man out, and he came out to call you on this, and a match ensued that we thought we would never see here.
Yes, so this man was in the building. I knew he was there, and I called him out. I unfortunately couldn't wrestle that evening, and I didn't want to disappoint the fans, so I sort of called somebody out and put together a match right on the spot.
And you're going to see that match. Coming up right now, let's go to it. All right, fans, we are back, and like we told you, we're going back to Wormwort. You can hear the music right there. It was set to be Metal Bob against Mark Stagg for the world title in a rematch from a few weeks ago on TV. But a big turn of events happened. You're going to see that in a second. Now the fans are all expecting to see Mark Stagg show up.
His opponent is the World Heavyweight Wrestling Champion, weighing in at 225 pounds, from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, the World Heavyweight Wrestling Champion, Mark Stagg!
Now you're about to see the announcement you saw at the beginning in its entirety. We're going to quiet it down here. No one knew at this point that then he came out in street clothes. Let's take a look.
You
can see Mark Stagg getting limping a little bit there.
I came to inform you that I can't wrestle tonight.
So the fans really erupted. Chance of refund filled the arena.
It was a charity event, the back says.
You could barely stand there.
Tough crowd.
So I win.
Always is at one point.
I win the match. He forfeits.
I hate to disappoint the fans, but
he forfeits.
They wouldn't let me wrestle.
Yeah, he asked him about, so he told me that because of the injury, he's up in the air right now, and I just can't wrestle. But no, what's the other thing? Yeah, raise my hand.
Now I don't know why you were calling out devastating Derek.
To see you, little Bob. What's up with Devastating Derek? Come on, Devastating Derek. What's up with Devastating Derek?
Wrestle Devastating Derek. Now, Devastating Derek was in the building, signing autographs and stuff, wasn't even set to wrestle here in World War.
No, he wasn't, but I knew he was in the building, and I didn't want to disappoint the fans. I wanted to give them their money's worth, and I thought this would be a good match, Devastating Derek versus Metal Bob.
What's wrong? You're afraid of your
Never before has this happened.
That
has nothing to do. Here in Night Wrestling Alliance,
Metal
Bob.
And I have grown up beating each other's ass.
Oh, my goodness.
It'll be nothing new to us. But I think this is a cop-out. I don't know if there's even anything wrong with that.
There's
I think your friend is a cop-out. I want to get Little Bob.
It's not that I want to rush. The doctors won't let me.
Yeah. Won't let you. Chicken!
That was saying Derek getting on your case. I don't think he knew the severity of the injury at this point. He just popped this out of nowhere. We now know we have medical documentation of the injury.
I hope he didn't after those comments. If he realizes now how...
I'm sure he's a... says he'll do it for the fans. Just in a pair of jogging pants and a shirt, and it gives you a little boost out of the ring there.
Oh, yeah, it gives me a little help there.
I don't believe that. As far as I'm concerned, I
Metal Bob are all upset. He wanted that world title.
Metal Bob always thinks there's a controversy going on somewhere.
There's always conspiracy in Metal Bob's mind. And most of the time he's right, damn it. The fans starting to chant Metal Bob. And Derek, it's about 50-50. There's a shake and a hug. Oh my goodness, oh my word. And a match, fans, you never thought was going to happen. Metal Bob against Devastating Derek, friends for some 21 years. What are you doing over there, Mark Stagg?
Please.
Oh my goodness.
Devastating
Derek
in the
rise. That's right. Backs him up in the ring. Look at those shots. These two are just going to go all out here, I guess. Oh, my God. That's his best friend. If he treats his best friend like that, what's he going to do against someone he hates? I know. He's going to throw a fireball at him.
Well, I don't think he hates me, I hope.
The blue Bobby.
Oh, now, come on. People getting on the... oh, my goodness. Here comes the collar and elbow. And now, Metal Bob retaliating with shots. Look at him go. Look at these two go.
Metal Bob, no slouch in the ring, because he's been a veteran of the ring for a long time.
Devastating Derek said that he and Metal Bob grew up beating each other's honeys, and this is nothing new to them. They're showing it here. Stagmare. Named for the aforementioned Mark Stagg.
Aforementioned?
I mentioned you a couple minutes ago.
Oh, okay.
What would you use here? You've wrestled both these men. What would you use here if you were Metal Bob to beat Devastating Derek, the former world champion, the first ever Intercontinental TV champion years ago? He was the first champion ever, won the tournament to crown the first champion of that. He was a world champion, tag team champion. What would you use to beat him if you were Metal Bob?
Well, I didn't really think of it at the moment, but...
besides a fireball.
I'm looking back at this match, and I didn't really think about now if Metal Bob, you know, was to defeat Devastating Derek in this match, the severity of what would take place. Devastating Derek's
either way,
priority.
If Devastating Derek beats Metal Bob, is that going to create, whichever man wins this contest, is that going to create dissidence within the...
Not necessarily that, but the elevation, the droppage, the ranking.
Oh, look at that, Metal Bob. Inviting the fans into the ring.
Metal Bob normally being the manager, if he really wanted to beat Devastating Derek first, so his ranking would go down.
Right.
He wants man to be dropped down in the standings.
Right.
We want to
then again, Metal Bob
himself.
Wants to keep having these world title shots. So he's got to elevate himself. This is a lose-lose situation, really, for either man. One, two. We're going to have to see how this one turns out, though. The referee is Rick Grace. I want to say hi to our good friend Jordan Torbett, wrote in. Gave me a nickname for Benjamin I'll be using when I get him back in the studio. I think he found out and ran.
Jordan, I'm sorry to hear about Benjamin.
I'm missing a letter.
And Jordan, as far as Bombshell goes, I'm sorry about that too. I'm sorry.
Oh, look at this. Oh, reverse atomic drop. We got a big write-in from a good friend of ours, Thomas P. Donovan. A wrestling fan for a long time, my friend. Again, you wanted some information. That'll be coming to you soon. Look forward to the newsletter coming out. We also want to talk about that newsletter after this contest. We have a couple special announcements about the newsletter. And myself and Mark Stagg will bring that to you after this. But first, let's get back to this big contest between Metal Bob and Devis. I can't even say it. They're wrestling each other. Metal Bob and Devastating Derek are in a heated battle in the middle of the squared circle, Mark Stagg. Did you ever think you'd see it?
No, I didn't, and kind of glad I put this together after that.
Well, I'll tell you what, you didn't want to disappoint the fans, and you didn't. You put together a match that's never happened before, I don't believe.
Well, it hasn't, as far as I understand.
One, two, grabbing onto the ropes. Oh, and Devastating Derek just hit Metal Bob in his little Bob, if you know what I mean.
Scoopy?
His little Leo.
Scoopy? I have a question for you, Johnny.
He's crawling out toward us.
Speaking of Jordan Torbett.
Not us, but the fans.
I wonder how Jordan feels about Benjamin taking... Well, I hear this Benjamin took Bombshell Billy's name.
Well, I don't want to get in. That's just stupid. Let's not add fuel to his ridiculous fire. He thinks people are going to call him Bombshell Benjamin from now on. That's just asinine. That's asinine. Still seeing Derek getting the fans rallied up. Wasn't even about to wrestle here. Just signing autographs and doing some things for the charity event. Doing some promotional work for it. Oh!
Big shoulder blocks there.
Just wearing his regular sneakers, jogging pants, and some kind of a crop shirt. Look at this.
Dropping across the top rope.
Oh, Metal Bob. Gonna go for a big slingshot. Oh my god, it flings him right over. Oh, onto the hard floor here. Linoleum. Linoleum floor. In the basement of the boys club here in Wormsworth, Minnesota. Little Bob looks like he's gonna plancha. He is. Oh, and a knee. Right on the head.
Drives a knee right in Devastating Derek.
They're not fighting like they're best friends. Oh, look at him use the second rope to catapult himself even higher to do more damage to his own best friend.
Personally, I didn't think this match would be such a brutal match when I signed it up, but thought maybe it'd be a nice scientific match.
The fans are shocked at ringside. They were stunned to see such a thing. They don't know who to cheer for. And, they're saying they're begging off a little bit. Metal Bob should know his own man's tricks. But they still try to use them on each other all the time. Oh my god! That is a straight forearm to the face.
Right there, Metal Bob decided to take advantage of the situation before Devastating Derek could.
Some kind of a table folded up at ringside here. St. Dirk is reaching for it. Who knows what he's going to do if
he gets
caught
on that. Actually choking his own man right here at this moment.
That's right. Well, he's holding onto the ropes for extra leverage. Oh, look at that. And he used that folded up table and bashed his own manager, his best friend. Oh, my, please. He just said, Ricky Grace, that thing slipped and hit Metal Bob. I wish that fan would stop whistling incessantly. It's ridiculous. Look at him putting a boot into the midsection of Metal Bob. Oklahoma side roll, Mark. One, two.
Oh, almost got him there.
On the count of two.
Sooner side roll.
Okay. He said it should have been a little bit quicker. A little bit quicker. Cowboy Bill Watts used to use that one. European uppercut that really catches Metal Bob in the jaw. And he follows in with a forearm, smash to the face. You can hear the Hicks out,
ooh,
the fans
right
out there.
Face of Metal Bob.
Wormsworth, I remember I was at it. I wasn't there for this card. I was there when we went through there about 4 months ago. A city that reminds me a lot of Fulton, New York. That kind of population. Not a real huge city, but they were in desperate need of help, and we came there to help them. That's what we did. Look at that, Nita. The back of the neck, snap the spine. The C1, the C2 of Metal Bob. Gone.
Both these men are spent at the moment.
Oh my God, I hate that one. That is a straight right hand to the forehead. Right there. Oh, and there's a headbutt. Knocks devastating Derek back between the ropes. This ring is a little smaller than the 20 by 20 we normally use for the UWA. This is about an 18 by 18.
Makes for high-paced action.
Sure does. It's gonna let him, oh my God, it just slams him down on that back.
Drops him in his lower lumbar area. Is it a bombshell rule?
Yeah, looks like it. He's got the ropes. Now he's not. One, two, puts his foot over the ropes. Devastating Derek as a ring generally knows where he is. What is that? Fans are chanting, we want bombshell. Well, I'm afraid to tell you, he's retired. Metal Bob takes exception to that.
They want Benjamin?
What?
They want Benjamin?
Yeah, they want bombshell Benjamin. Now, come on, that's not necessary. Hard and heavy, the fans are chanting. You got a better chance of seeing Lou Fez come down here and Atomic Drop Metal Bob.
Oh, right
and,
here.
Buddy Rogers slapped him in a sleeper.
Devastating Derek drops.
Swinging! Neck, full Nelson. Ken Patera, Billy Jack Haynes like. Sits out of it. Metal Bob.
Problem with Billy Jack Haynes.
Metal Bob does exactly what he's supposed to do in this move. He sits out to relieve the pressure. When he's standing up, all the pressure is on his neck. Now he's sat down, he's hunched over to relieve some of that pressure off of his spine. Beautifully done.
I hope Devastating Derek doesn't have the same problem Billy Jack Haynes had.
For Metal Bob's sake, I hope
Metal
he doesn't
Bob have problem. Problem. In trouble. Ricky Grace ran the action as usual.
La puka oblongata. Oh my God, Metal Bob.
The fans are on the case of both these men at the moment.
Oh, almost an axe bomber type move. We'll come in. There's a clothesline.
One thing that I know the fans.
Listen to the fans. Look at that bridge by Metal. One, two. Holy cow.
One thing I know the fans are definitely used to, fast-paced action. Non-stop action here in the Wrestling Alliance. And I hope, me speaking for the rest of the wrestlers, that you get that to them every weekend, week out.
Look at these two really punching each other in the head and doing it hard. They are really going at it.
Breaks the eyes. Breaks
they're
the
best
eyes
friends. Again. Look at this. Oh my God. There's a rake to the eyes that stops all of this.
Fortunately, in that position, the leverage is not the greatest, so impact of those punches.
Could be a bonsai drop. Could be a gorilla press. Gorilla splash. Oh, the knee. It's a Ray the Crippler Stevens like knee.
Close to cross the throat there. Ricky Grace should be a little closer on the action.
Metal Bob.
Fans at ringside are definitely siding with Devastating Derek at the moment.
What is Metal Bob's, Iron Mike Bob's problem?
Exactly.
All right. He's proud of that. He's proud of the fact that he's Iron Mike Bob. Oh, my gosh.
Big clothesline by devastating Derek Knox's manager down.
I hope you're thinking about the big trivia thing, because we're going to be bringing the pitcher in its entirety soon, very soon. You're not going to believe this. You're not going to believe this.
Devastating Derek going up for the second.
Grabbing onto the pipe. Oh, Alabama Jam. Alabama Jam. Two. It's a, oh, my God, he got him. He got him with that one. Holy cow. Devastating Derek coming out with a big victory over his own man.
Flying leg drop takes out his man, Metal Bob.
I'm your winner. Kicking that
out. Oh, come on now. Oh, he's still swinging. Metal Bob doesn't know what happened. He just got Alabama jammed. We want Stag, the fans are chanting.
Well, I was going to be out for a while. I was up in that second ring at the moment.
Oh, that's great. They call Metal Bob the Booger Man. Oh, my goodness.
Well,
oh, my goodness. That's a matter of opinion. That is a matter of opinion.
Derek was definitely heated at the moment after going through a match with Metal Bob like that.
I can't believe it. I never thought I'd see the day the Devastating Derek Metal Bob would go at it, but I just did. And quite frankly, I'm speechless. I am speechless. Fans, we've got something very special for you coming up. We'll be right back with that after that.
Did you ever wonder what happened to the War Eagle and Scotty McCloud, and if they'll ever return to the United Wrestling Alliance? What about Diablo? What's he going to steal next? Are Hard and Heavy ever going to...
All right, fans, this is Johnny Keelgood. I'm going to bust in here for a second during the newsletter commercial because I want to give you readers a chance, or excuse me, you fans a chance. We need you to write in. We want to have some readers' pages. We're going to print your letters. That's right. In the newsletter, we want to have a reader's page where we are going to print some of the letters written in from us to us from you fans. So please, write in. We can get some answers maybe for you from Mark Stagg or any other of the wrestlers. If you have questions, whatever, write in. We're going to print your questions. We're going to print your letters if you have comments or whatever. Please write into the reader's pages. Thank you.
Where's his mask now? Will he ever come back? Well, the Thunder and Tiger and the Mystic, on their tour of Japan, who did they beat up? What's Teresa Steele's plans now that Bombshell Billy has retired? You can find all this out by writing to us and giving us your address so we can send you the United Wrestling Alliance official news bulletin, the UWA newsletter. We are going to give you all the late breaking news, including columns from Johnny Keelgood, interviews with wrestlers, also a column by Benjamin Halifax called The House of Halifax. Is the disco
just added reader's pages?
Why does Metal Bob even wear a mask? You can find that out by writing to us. Please do it.
Wrestling fans, that can mean only one thing. The trivia. We're back, Mark Stagg, with the...
I'm just dying to find out who this is.
Third installment. That's how much you've got so far. And we're going to bring it down a little bit more. We're going to go down here. Just a little bit.
Magoo, can I get some more of this picture, please?
How about that?
Can I get a little more?
No, you can't.
Come on.
Not until after. We're going to show you the full picture. If you don't have it by now, then you're a pig in a poke. That's as far as they're going to go, they tell me. We've got another hint fire, though. We got another hint fire. This man has been the world heavyweight champion.
The world heavyweight champion?
He has been the world heavyweight champion.
What world heavyweight champion? United Wrestling Alliance?
The United Wrestling Alliance World Heavyweight Champion he has been in. This is, again, a picture of him in his rookie year.
Do we have a year on that?
It was like 84, 85.
Hmm.
84, I believe.
Probably should know this, shouldn't I?
I don't know. I can't figure it out. It looks like I'm going to make a guess and say that that's Metal Bob.
Metal Bob? Are you nuts?
I've never seen him without his mask. I don't know what he looks like.
I don't think Metal Bob's ever wrestled without a mask.
Yeah, you've seen him without his mask. You grew up with him.
I've seen him without his mask, but I don't think he's ever wrestled without a mask.
That's what I'm, well, I don't know.
He's got, looks like he has some sort of weird glasses on here. I don't know what it is.
Weird glasses. Weird pink, and I see pink and green, and I see pink.
Green.
A little pink on there.
And blue. Oh, it's UWA.
Let's talk for a second. You're waiting for Neon Deon to call and talk about what's going to happen with the title and your status. Any thoughts? Do you know when you're going to be able to? Do you know when you're going to be able to come back?
Well, as far as I know I'm out for at least 2 weeks, and I've been out for a week so far, so it's going to be 2 to 3 weeks. Hopefully, I'll be able to defend my belt with a 30-day mandatory time slot. But I'm waiting to hear from the doctors to give me the okay, because they won't really get in the ring. It's not only they don't want to get in the ring, it's they won't let me get in the ring until I'm medically cleared. And they have to also go through me on Dan Lobatos, and hopefully get the okay to get back in the ring before the 30 days and defend my belt.
All right, fans, they're going to black out the pitcher, I believe. They've given you enough time to figure that out, and we're going to come back with the full picture. Right after this, we're going to go to Lord James Taylor and the pre-taped Thanksgiving Thunder update is not going to be shown this week. We're going to go to a live one. We have him right here in the studio, the one that was originally taped to be shown on our regular show. We've scrapped. We've got him right here, so let's get down to that, see if we can't figure out what's going on at Thanksgiving Thunders. Further ado, let's go down to Lord James Taylor. He's in Studio B, and he is ready to bring you the update. Fake devil, let's talk about. I've just got word from Neon Deon Lobatos about Mark Staggs. He says to me that if Mark Staggs cannot defend that title in the allotted 30 days, that the title will be held up and put in the main event at Thanksgiving Thunder. I've heard rumblings that Bombshell Billy wants to be a part of Thanksgiving Thunder. That's what I've heard this week. I'm not sure what capacity, if he'll be another special guest referee, or if he has something else up his sleeve. You never know with this Bombshell Billy. He's always up to no good. But he's going to be at Thanksgiving Thunder in some capacity. That's what I've been assured. I've also had word that the camp of Devastating Derek and Metal Bob want to get their hands on that world title, and they might be able to do so at Thanksgiving Thunder, but we're not sure yet. Nothing has been solidified in stone. I don't know if the Thunder Tiger and the Mystic are going to be wrestling against a tag team. I'm not sure what's going on thus far. I do know Bombshell Billy said he wants to be a part of it somehow, whether that's refereeing again or not, I'm not sure. And I also know that if Mark Staggs cannot put his little footy, his little booty on, and get in the ring, that they're going to take that title from him, that light bright making things with light. They're going to take that from him. They're going to put it up in the main event at Thanksgiving Thunder. And whoever comes out, whatever the main event might be, the fans are going to help us pick it. We're going to flick it. Neon Deon will stick it at Thanksgiving Thunder. Back up to you people up there, Johnny Gielgud and Mark Staggs. I hope you can get back in the ring, me friend, or else I'm going to pull the belt right out from under your nose, you little bugger. Back up to you, Johnny, me good friend, you filthy. All right, that's enough out of you. I've heard enough out of you. Mark, you just heard that announcement. If you cannot defend within 30 days, it's going to go up in the tournament at Thanksgiving Thunder.
Well, I don't like it, but I know that's the rules, that's the way it goes, and hopefully I'll be able to get back to the ring before the 30 days is up.
All right, what we want to do right now is bring you to the final trivia shot of the day.
We're going to see who this is?
We're going to see who this is.
Fantastic.
All right, fans, we are back with the big, big finale of the trivia. So far, we've got World Tag Team Champion. World Champion has had two managers. I guess it's time for us to take a look at one last time. Can you venture a guess?
I am not sure. I think I have an inkling.
Oh, but what do you think it is? I think it's Benjamin Halifax the third.
Benjamin Halifax the third? Could be. Could very well be.
Looks a little bit like James Taylor, the way he dresses.
I don't think he was a rookie back in 1984.
That's true. He was a rookie back in 74.
1874.
All right, that's enough. He's going to have our eyes. He's going to shove apples up our... Now then, have you have a guess? Well, let's go ahead and take a look at it. Are you ready?
Let's go ahead.
Oh, what? Magoo, is that right?
Is that who I think
Magoo
it is?
Magoo says it's Bombshell Billy.
Bombshell Billy?
In his rookie year at an outdoor event, and this is at a park he was wrestling at. Coming
what
out of the clubhouse, his rookie year, he was known as Beautiful Billy.
Star's born right there. We tell you something.
Pretty Boy Billy? Pretty Boy Billy. I've been corrected. Pretty Boy Billy. Oh, my gosh. Look at him, will ya?
Be cool. Well, I don't know how you can be cool with that outfit.
1900, circa 1984. Some 12 years ago. Take a look.
Yankees. I can't believe that one.
Oh,
Shawn Billy. Who'd have thunk it?
Who'd have what?
Thunk it.
Not me. Not looking like that. Not dressing like that.
No, not at all.
I have a feeling you went home alone a lot back then. Bombshell Billy, the man who is now retired, but says he wants to be a part of Thanksgiving Thunder. Do you have any hopes for Thanksgiving Thunder? Anything you want to do? Do you want to defend your
like
world
I said,
title,
the,
hopefully?
The fans are, I guess the fans are picking the main event, but I just want to be there. I want to be a part of it, and hopefully it'll be in the main event.
Hopefully defending your world
champion.
Title.
But time will tell as we go along here.
That's right. I guess we're about ready to get out of here, fans.
Heels, but, thanks for having me on the show this week.
Let's
and,
go to the closing video. Mark and myself will take this out of here. Look at that.
Oh. Turn me down, will you?
I've got a golden shower.